It was the middle of winter, December 1924. Jimmy Fellhaber lived on a ranch up in the Okanagan. He was sent on an errand to a neighboring ranch. He took a shortcut he was told not to take through a ravine, and he never came home. Welcome to Mossbacks Northwest. Out of the den, we're in a den of a different kind. The mammal department of the Burke Museum. So in the 1920s, there was a fatal cougar attack. It was an attack that generated national publicity, which suggests that even as we were coming out of the frontier period, cougar attacks were very rare, they're very unusual, and they scared the bejesus out of people. Over 40% of Washington is considered suitable cougar habitat. You can hike your entire life in the Washington wilds and never see a cougar. But cougars are sometimes a problem for ranchers, farmers, and occasionally they will attack something they usually don't attack. These are the bones of a cougar that was killed in Renton in the 1980s, and it was going after killing chickens. This cougar had a lot of physical problems. At some point, the cougar had a terrible encounter with a porcupine, and the porcupine's quills actually worked their way into the cougar's bone. And that also caused a bone-like tumor to form. So this is a cougar who was probably very distressed, and this cougar was shot because it was creating problems. The interesting part of the story with little Jimmy Fellhaber was in the ensuing weeks, there were more than one tracking team. They each tracked a cougar down and killed the cougar. And then there was a big dispute over who got the right one. One group's cougar was stuffed and is on display at the Okanagan County Museum in Eastern Washington. I've come across cougar tracks in the wild. Makes you look at your environment very differently and more carefully. If you do encounter a cougar in the wild, you need to stand your ground and not run. And of course, I can't imagine trying to push down that instinct not to run, but that's often a trigger for a cougar to come get you.